is the table given below to find the actual class limit of the fourth class. Actual class limit of the fourth class. So these class intervals, they are given in inclusive or exclusive?
Inclusive.
Are they, these are inclusive. 32, 34, 35 to 39, 40 to 44, 45 to 49, 50 to 54, 55 to 59. And their frequency, this is, these are class intervals, frequency 7, 10, 12, 13, 8, 4. Okay, so first question is the actual class limits of the fourth class. Fourth class is for second, third, fourth. So fourth class is 45 to 49. These are in inclusive form. These class intervals are in inclusive form. Lower limit is included, upper limit is as well included. You can see 44, then starts from 45, 45 to 49. So we have to make them actual class limits, means we have to make them exclusive. So this class interval we have to make exclusive. How we can make exclusive? So first we have to find the adjustment factor. What will be the adjustment factor? 45 minus 44. Adjustment factor. 45 minus 44 divided by 2, it is 0.5. It means we subtract 0.5 from the lower limit and we will add 0.5 to the upper limit. So what will be the class interval now? 44.5 to 49.5. This is the actual class limits, actual class interval. Actual class limits they are asking. So actual class limits are 44.5. It is the actual lower limit. It is the actual upper limit of the fourth class. This is clear?
Yes,
okay. Second one, the class boundaries of the sixth class. Class boundaries of the sixth. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. 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 Fourth. Fourth. Second. Fourth. Of the sixth class boundaries. What are class boundaries? They are actual class limits. They are actual class limits. We have already studied on page number 226. There, you have read the definition. The actual or the true class limits are also called as class boundaries. So find the class boundaries here. Again, 0.5 was the adjustment factor. So it will be how much? Subtract it from the lower limit. 54.5 to 59.5. This will be the answer. Actual class boundaries. Okay, class mark of the third class. Class mark of the third class. First, second, third. Class mark doesn't change whether it's inclusive or exclusive. It's the middle value. Third, what will be the class mark? How to take the class mark? Middle value we have to take. 40 plus 44 divided by 2. What will be the answer? Class mark. 40 plus 44 divided by 2. What it will be? 84 divided by 2. 42. So class mark is 42. Third class mark is 42. The upper and lower limits of the fifth class. They are not asking the actual. They are simply asking the upper and lower limits of the fifth class. So upper and lower limits, they are 50 and 54. They are 50 and 54. Okay. The size of the third class. What is the size of the third class? Size of the third class. First, second, third. So read the definition once. Whether should we take the lower limits and upper limits of these or the actual upper limits, we have to take the difference. So read the definition here, 226, class size. The difference between the actual lower limit and the actual upper limit. So first, we need to convert this third class into actual lower limits and actual upper limit you have to convert. Actual class intervals you have to convert. So how much it will be? 0.5 you have to subtract from 40 and 0.5 you have to add. It will be 39.5 to third class, okay, 44.45. This will be the actual class limits. Now take the difference. What will be the difference? How much is the difference? Take the difference. Is it 5? So 5 is the class size. Understood now? Always remember these definitions on page number 226. Adjustment factors we have done. Actual class limits, class boundaries, they are same. Then class size is taken between the actual class limits. The difference between the actual class limits. Class mark, whether you can take difference between the actual class, whether you can take the medial value between the actual class limits or the given class limits, it won't change. Usually it is defined between the actual class limits. You can take these also because it's the mid value. So no change. This is clear? Okay, 8th one.
Yes, sir.
The cumulative frequency I will tell along with 8th question. We'll discuss 8th question along with cumulative frequency. What does it mean? Okay. So we have discussed frequency till now. It is particular number, how many times it is appearing. Okay. Or consider these as the marks of a student. It marks of students. It means number of students scoring between 30 and 34. Or including 30 and 34, how many students are there? 7. And 35 and 39, marks between 35 and 39, including these boundaries as well, they are 10. These are frequency, number of students. Now we discuss cumulative frequency. What does it mean? Okay. So along with, I'll be discussing, I will take the 8th first question. We'll discuss along with that. Okay. So everyone pay attention, it's important now. Cumulative frequency will be using afterwards in drawing the polygon as well, frequency polygon. Okay. So I'm making the table. 0 to 8. So first we have the class intervals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Here we have the class interval. 0 to 8, 8 to 16, 24, 32 to 40. These are class intervals. Which kind of they are? Inclusive or exclusive?
Exclusive.
We'll always take the exclusive form. Okay. Now the frequency. Nine, 13, 12, 7, 15. Okay. Now we'll be drawing cumulative frequency. Here, cumulative frequency. Cumulative means we are taking the sum of them. Okay. Two sum we are taking. We are going to take the sum of the frequencies. How we are going to take the sum of the frequencies? So in cumulative frequency, how we consider this? First column, it will be considered as first row less than 8. You already know what does it mean. Any value, it will be 0 will be included, upper limit is excluded always. So it won't be equal. Equal sign won't be there. Similarly here, x 16. This is inclusive and this is exclusive. So upper limit is not included. This is exclusive form. Upper limits are not included. Therefore, see a first class interval, how we are saying? Less than 8. 8 is not included here. So all the values, for example, consider these as the marks of the students, for example. So all the number of students who have scored less than 8 marks are how many? 9 are there. This is cumulative frequency. Okay. Now, as you take the second row, how we are going to put it, if we are considering cumulative frequency, less than 16. It means all this number of students who have scored less than 16. It means these also will be included. Yes. Less than 16 means those who have scored between 0 to 8 as well, they are included. So it will be 9 plus 13. How much it is? 20. So less than 16 means 22. So we are adding 9 plus 13, 22. Understood? So how many students have scored less than 16? 22. Next one, less than 24. So how many students have scored less than 24? It means all three we are going to add. 9 plus 13 plus 12. How much it will, or we can add 12 to 24. How much it will be? 30? How much?
34.
So 34 students have scored less than 24. 34 students have scored less than 34. Okay, next one. How many students have scored less than 32? Add them all. 9 plus 13 plus 12 plus 7. Or else, add 7 to this one. How much it will be? How much? 41?
41.
Okay. How many students have scored less than 40?
Less than 40?
41 plus 15. It means 9 plus 13 plus all their sum. 13 plus 12 plus 7 plus 15. How much it will be? 60 or 56. 56. So 56 students. This is clear? Have you understood? So, see, if I ask you how many students have scored less than 40 marks. Less than 40 marks, these all students have scored. It means 56 students have scored less than 40 marks. So this is nothing but cumulative frequency. Less than?
Sir, we have 40. To write less than 8, less than 15.
You don't have to write. You don't have to write these. This is just to explain you. Okay? Just for the explanation. So it's better you write in one question. Okay? So that you understand well. Afterwards, stop writing. So that while revising, you will know that this way we have to do. Okay? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. As well, you can read on page number 227 on top CA. Cumulative frequency of a class interval is the sum of all the frequencies of all classes up to that class. Including the frequency of that particular class, okay? So there you can see how it is given, less than 10, less than 20, okay? Is this clear? Okay. Second one, try second one. How to do the second one? Class intervals are not inclusive. Class intervals are not inclusive. So, make them inclusive first and then write the cumulative frequency. Everyone do that. 8 seconds. Everyone try 8 seconds. Everyone do the 8 seconds. Try it. So if it is not, it is given inclusive form, first convert into exclusive form and then do. So here you will find in some books they are doing inclusive, they have kept, they have solved using exclusive. And some books they are converting it into exclusive form. So it's better to convert in exclusive form. Because afterwards, the histogram will be drawn, will require exclusive classes, as well as for the frequency polygon, will require exclusive classes. Okay, so what is the adjustment factor for the second one? What are the adjustment factors?
0.5.
Okay, so first class intervals, these are the actual 20, 21 to 30, 31 to 40, and 41 to 50. See, HO class limits, convert it, find the adjustment factor first, everyone. Find the adjustment factor. What will be the adjustment factor? So 11 minus 10 divided by 2. So it will be 0.5. Okay, separate it from the lower limits and add to the upper limits. So 0.5 to 10.5. 10.5 to 20.5. 20.5 to 30.5, 30.5 to 40.5, 40.5 to 50.5. This is the actual class intervals, frequency, cumulative frequency. Frequency, cumulative frequency. 12, 18, 23. 15, 10, okay, 12, add them, 30, these two add, 30, 30 plus 23, 53, add it, keep adding them, so these all, some of these, so it will be 8, 68, and 78. Is this clear? Have you constructed all? Frequency distribution?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next one. Ninth, do as homework. Okay. Ninth question, do as homework. Okay. We'll start with 10. So now from cumulative frequency, we'll draw the frequency table. From the cumulative frequency distribution table, we'll draw the frequency table. Okay. So try 10th one. Everyone try 10th one. Everyone try 10 form. So here you can write the class intervals. Cumulative frequency, if you want to write, you can write, or directly you can write frequency. Okay. If you want to write cumulative frequency, you can write, or you can write directly the frequency, okay? For example, I'm writing cumulative frequency and then frequency, okay? So first class interval, less than 10. Less than 10 means number of frequency table for the following. Number of students, marks. Marks cannot be negative. It can start from 0. So start from 0, 0 to 10, okay? Less than 10, how many students? Cumulative frequency, 6, okay? And then 10 to 20, 15, and 20, it's up to 60, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and last is 50 to 60. These are the class intervals and correspondingly cumulative frequency, 6, 15, 30, 39, 53, 70. So you can read there less than 10, 6. So frequency is 6. Now these are less than 20. So 0 to 10, we have to remove from that group. Less than 20, it is given. Okay, we can write like this. Less than 20, less than 30, less than 40, less than 50, less than 60. So see here, less than 20, it means this class interval is also included. We have to exclude this class interval. It means from 15, we will subtract 6. So how much it will come? 15 minus 6, 9. So 6 students will lie in this group and 9 will lie in this group. Next is 20 to 30. Less than 30 is given, 30 students. So we have to remove them. We have to remove 15. So 30 minus 15, 15 will be there. In this group, so we have to remove these all. It means from less than 40 is 39. From this, we'll remove less than 30. 39 minus 30, 9. Similarly, from this, less than 50 will remove less than 40. All will be removed. 53 minus 39. 53 minus 39. Okay, so 53 minus 39, 13, 4, 14. Okay, next one, less than 60, we have 70. From this, we'll subtract less than 50, 53. 7, 17. Is this clear? So from cumulative frequency, we have calculated frequency. Is this clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, try 11. Everyone try 11th. 11th one, everyone try. We have to construct frequency distribution table. Again, number of students, it means age cannot be negative. It will start from 0. 0 means no one has born. Okay, so start from 0. Below 4, 0 points, okay. Draw that one. So first make the class intervals. Ages below 4. Below 4 means less than 4, less than 7, less than 10, less than 13, less than 16. Number of students 0, 85. It means these are cumulative frequencies. 140, 243, 300. Class intervals less than 4, 0 to 4, 4 to 7, 7 to 10. 10 to 13, 13 to 16. Okay. Now what we have to answer? State the number of students in the age group 10 to 13. Either you calculate for each and then you tell, or you can do it directly from this. 10 to 13, how many students are? 10 to 13 number of students. In this age group, how many students are there? It means this frequency we need. How many they are? Less than 10, they are 140. And less than 13, 243. So how many are there? 243 minus 140. These are the number of students having age between 10 and 13, including 10. So how many they are? 243 minus 140?
103.
103. So 103 students are having age 10 to 13. This is age. Okay. Next one. State the age group which has the least number of students. Which has the least number of students. It means we need to find the frequency first and then we have to compare. Okay. So least, which group is there? So 0 to 4, how many students are there? 0. Below 4, 0. 4 to 7, 85. How many are there in this age group? 140 minus 85. 140 minus 85. How much it will be? 5 and 13. 5. 55. Here, 103. And in last, subtract them. How much it will be? 50?
57.
57. Now, which group is having the least number of students?
First, 0 to 4.
0 to 4, that's 0. Okay. Which has the least number of students? Okay. Below 40 students. Okay, 1 minute. Usually, this class has to be excluded when we draw the frequency table. Okay, so class it will start from 4 to 7 usually, and answer will be this one. Okay, which is having the frequency 0, we usually avoid that. We exclude that one. So it is 7 to 10, which is having the least number of students. Understood? So we will exclude this class interval. So our class interval will start from 4 to 7, 7 to 10, 10 to 13, 13 to 10. Okay. So 7 to 10, they are having the least number of students. Okay. Okay. Reason you can get it from page number 227. Open page number 227 once. Now see the cumulative frequency, those two tables are given. First one check, they are starting from 10 to 20, frequency 4, cumulative frequency 4. Okay, now check the less than table. Less than 10 they are starting from. So they are providing us the lower limit, that is, it is starting from 10. They are providing, kind of providing us the lower limit, that is starting from 10. The first class interval will be from 10 to 20. Understood that one? So first class interval, first class, first they have provided less than 10. It means they are providing the lower limit from where the classes are going to start, the limit from where they're going to start. So our class intervals will start from 4 to 7. We'll exclude this one. Understood this one? Just to provide us the starting point. That is
the 4 to 7.
Yes, our first class interval will be 4 to 7. First, they have provided just to provide us the limit. You can see page number 227, that's an important example. 10 to 20 in frequency distribution table. But see, less than 10 they have written. That is just to provide us the lower limit. That is from 10 it will start, zero number. Okay, so similarly here, we are going to avoid this one. And what will be the answer? 7 to 10. Okay, understood now? Okay. Do the 12th one. Class interval, frequency, cumulative frequency. 25 to 34, what will be the frequency?
15.
15. It will be 15. Okay. Then 35 to 44. Cumulative frequency 28 is given. So,
13.
13. 28 minus 15. That will be the frequency there. 45 to 54, frequency 21 is given. Cumulative frequency, that means we 34. Have to add 34. 28 plus 21. No, 28 plus 31. 40. How much it will be?
So 49.
49 it will be. Okay. So let me draw it so that. Okay. Twenty-five to thirty-four, thirty-five to forty-four, forty-five to fifty-four, fifty-five to sixty-four, sixty-five to seventy-four, seventy-five to eighty-four. Now here frequency is given, not given, 21, 16, and 12. And here cumulative frequency is given, 15, 28, And here 73. And here we have to calculate. Okay. So first one, see here. It's the commutative frequency 15. It starts from 25 to 34. It means here 15 will be there. Now here we have to calculate what is the frequency. It means less than 44. All are included. These two are included here, 28. So from 28 we will subtract 15. How much it is? 13. Frequency is 13. Now to find the commutative frequency, it means their sum we have to take. Their sum we have to take. Oh, 20. Their sum is 28. We already taken. 28 plus 21. How much it will be? 49. Now here as well.
49.
Less than 64. So how much it will come here?
55
plus 10, 65. Okay, now this one you have to calculate. Frequency here. It means less than 64, how many? 65. And 74, 73. So we have to subtract that. 73 minus 65 will give this one. So how much it will? 8. 8 will be there. Okay. Now here, it means these all will be added. 73 plus 12, how much it will be? 80. How much?
85.
These are frequencies, these are commutative. It means this plus this will give this. Their sum, this, their sum, here. And their sum total here. If you have to calculate this one, how to calculate this one? So less than 64, 65. Less than 54, 49. Their difference will give us this interval. Understood? Okay, try next one. 13. The value of pi up to 50 decimal place is given. Up to 50 decimal place. Okay, actually pi is a rational number or irrational number?
Irrational number.
What kind of decimal number is it? It is
non-terminating
and non-recurring.
Non-repeating,
as I said. So it does not repeat and it does not terminate. So if it does not terminate, it never repeats. Non-recurring. Okay. That's why it's a irrational number. Okay. So the value of pi is given to us. And mark a frequency distribution table for the digits from 0 to 9. From 0 to 9 after the decimal place. Okay. That is 0, how many times 0 is appearing? Okay. So if we draw the table, here will be the digit. And here will be the frequency. How many times that digit is appearing? Okay. So digits we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So for this, you have to make the tally marks as well, I think. So here we make the tally marks and then the frequency. Okay, frequency. Okay, start from there. Start from 3. 3. I will start in new notebook. 3, 1, 4, 5, 9, 2, 9, 2, 6, 5, 3, 6, 5, 3, 5, 8, 9, 5, 8, 9, 7, 9, 3, 7, 9, 3. Okay, if I make mistake, do let me know. 7, 9, 3, we have done. 2, 3, 8. 2, 3, 8. 4, 6, 2. 4, 6, 2. 6, 4, 3. 6, 4, 3. 3, 8, 3. 3, 8, 3. 2, 2, 7, 9, 2, 7, 9, 5, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 8, 8, 4, 8, 8, 4, 1 9 7 1 9 7 1 6 9 1 6 9 3 9 9 3 9 9 3 7 5 3 7 5 1 0 1 0. Okay, have you made the same? Okay, 9 8 you got. Okay, we'll do a little fast. So how many times zero is appearing? 2 times 4 times 5 times 5 9 times 4 times 5 times 4 times 4 times 5 times 5 8 times. Whether is it 2 5 5 8 2? Okay, check once. One, we have made mistake with one, I think. 1 2 3 4 5. One is more there. 5 3 5 4 3 is 8 times. We have made mistake here. 8. Okay. 2 5 5 8 4 5 4 4 5 8. This will be there. Okay. Have you got the same?
Yes, sir.
You all got the same? I have done it earlier as well, so I know I have the answers. Okay. Is this clear? Okay. Now, yes, make sir. A frequency distribution table we have made. Okay. Okay. After the decimal place. After the decimal place it was. So 3 we should not have included. It is the 8 times. Okay. After the decimal place only we have to take. So first 3 we started, that was wrong. That's why we got 9 here. Okay. Which are the most and the least occurring digits? Which are the most and least occurring digits? Most, which one is the most occurring digits? Highest frequency?
3 and 9.
Least occurring? Least occurring digit?
0.
0. 0 is the least occurring digit. Okay. So with this, we end this chapter. Okay. On Monday, we'll start the new chapter. Today, 12:30, you are having parent-teachers meeting. Okay. This is clear. We'll start the graphical representation. Just go through it once afterwards. Okay. Thank you all. Yes. Anything you want to ask?
Getting to be here today.
Ask again.
Sir, 18th B.
18th B we'll be doing. From Monday we'll start. Okay. You can just go through it. If you want to get the idea, you can just go through it. 18th B will start. It's important as well. Histogram and all. Histogram and frequency polygon we'll discuss. Okay. On Monday we'll discuss.